When you add an app to Clever, you need to specify what data the app should have access to. For instance, a middle school art app might need access to 6th through 8th grade art sections. You share data by setting data sharing rules, specific parameters for data you want Clever to share with an app, like those art sections. This ensures you share only the data an app needs and nothing more. You have two ways to specify what data you wish to share with an app. If you're newer to data sharing, you can use our more supportive guided sharing experience. Or if you're more experienced, you can use our standard sharing experience. You'll find both experiences by going to the Applications tab of your dashboard and clicking Request Applications or an existing application's sharing rules. Here's what guided sharing looks like for the app Flowcabulary. Notice how there are a few quick steps with lots of supportive context around what each sharing type means. You can share data based on specific sections, teachers, students, schools, and more. You can even copy the sharing rules from another app, saving you time if the new app needs similar rules. In addition, you may see a recommended data sharing template from the app if its team has this set up. Generally, these recommendations reflect the licensing agreement you have with the app. This can save you a lot of time since the app has done most of the legwork for you. After you complete the steps in the guided sharing process, the data you've specified will be shared with that app. On the other hand, our standard sharing experience is perfect for folks who have been around the block a couple of times. You might find standard sharing particularly useful if you want to add a lot of specific conditions or are in a larger district with a lot of schools. For example, maybe you're piloting a reading app across 20 of your 100 elementary schools. Standard sharing might be a little easier to use. For this demo, we're going to select the app MathSpace. You have a few options similar to those seen in guided sharing, but you have an additional customized sharing option. This is a powerful tool for sharing specific data. Want to take a look? When you click Customize Sharing, you'll be taken to this screen. From here, you can select to share by categories such as student, section, teacher, and staff. For instance, let's say we want to share MathSpace with all high school math sections. You'll click Share by Section. You'll say you want to share data with MathSpace when the subject equals math. Then, you'll drill down further by adding a filter that says the section grade must equal 9, 10, 11, or 12. To recap, this rule will share any math sections within grades 9 through 12, along with the sections, students, and teachers with the MathSpace app. For our data sharing to take hold, we must save and confirm. You'll know when your data is shared when you see the green confirmation box. Once you've added a first rule by clicking the Add Rule button, you can then add any additional rules you might need. Please note that when you add an additional rule, the rules are mutually exclusive. For example, if you add another rule that shares all sections with the subject of technology, you'll be sharing both all high school math sections and all technology sections. This means if you want to build off of an existing rule, you'll want to add a filter to the rule itself rather than create a new rule entirely. You can edit an existing rule by clicking the pencil button next to the rule. Below your rule, you'll see a list of data that meet these criteria, so you can make sure that the rule you're using correctly captures the data you want. Finally, you'll also notice that you can add a note to your rule. This is perfect for documenting why you set it up in a certain way or what its purpose was, in case another district admin is ever modifying data sharing. By the way, for both guided and standard sharing, the rules you determined are dynamically updating. For instance, if tomorrow you add 3 new high school math sections to your Student Information System, or SIS, those sections will be included once they sync with Clever. They'll then be included the next time the MathSpace app syncs with Clever, since you specified that all high school math sections should be shared with MathSpace. Last, if you start in one setup experience but wish to switch to guided or standard sharing, simply click the switch button as shown here. Ta-da! And there you have it, a rundown on how to specify what data you want sent to your applications in Clever. I hope I didn't overshare.